MetaPict is a regular library that makes it easy to produce vector graphics. You can save the results as PDF, SVG, or PNG. The ideas behind MetaPict was inspired by MetaFont, MetaPost, and Tikz. First, I will show you a few examples of what can be done with MetaPict. Now, anyone that has read the elements by Euclid certainly knows these diagrams. Eocene was inspired by a particular edition, the one by Thomas Heath. His code is available at GitHub. This example is of a more artistical nature. It is Hadi who wrote the MetaPict code, and he was inspired by a series of similar artistic figures by Hamid Naderi. His code is also available at GitHub. This example is by Zachary Romero. He was inspired by the tradition of tessellation in the Muslim world. He has written a library, so you can use his library to make your own tessellations. We are now going to look at a few code examples. This first example draws a curve from the point 0,0 to 1,1 and then continues to 1,0. The frame at the right shows the default window. The center of the default window is 0,0, the top right is 1,1, and the left bottom corner is -1.-1. Not all drawings fit in the square from -1 to 1 on the x-axis and from -1 to 1 at the y-axis. The form with window allows you to use a different window. In this example, the x range goes from 0 to 2 and the y range from 0 to 2. The actual curve is drawn from the same points, but due to the different window, the placement of the curve is different. This example shows that MetaPict has a lot of built-in shapes. At the middle of the screen, you see the unit circle and the unit square. A sector of the unit circle has been filled out with red. At the top right, we see an ellipse. And at the bottom right, we see a star. And at the bottom left, we see a rectangle. The form curve constructs a curve from a given set of points. Between the curves, you need to write how the points are connected. In this example, dash dash is used to connect the points, the straight line segments. This example uses the same four points as before. This time, the points are connected using dot dot. The dot dot means that curves should find a pretty curve that goes through the points. This example features the same four points. This time, the connector is horizontal, then vertical. So if you look at how A and B are connected, you see that the curve first moves horizontal and then vertical up to B. And from B to C, again, first horizontal, then vertical. And from C to D, horizontal, and then vertical. This example shows the vertical, then horizontal way of connecting the points. So far we have only drawn open curves. If you need the curve to form a closed loop, you can end the path specification in curve with the keyword cycle. We have now seen quite a few ways of constructing curves. Now let's back up a little and look at the example where we connected the points with a pretty curve. At the right, we see the default pretty curve. in order to change how the pretty curve behaves, it's possible to add vectors before and after a point. In this example, we have added the vector 1, minus 1 after the point B. The vector shows the direction in which the curve exits the point. So if you look at the figure, you can see that the red vector here is tangent to the curve. Here, we added the up vector after A. So this time the curve starts from A, goes straight up over to B, exits B in the direction 1, minus 1, continues to C and ends in D. We have now seen how to construct curves. When we have a curve, we can draw the curve. The operation draw simply draws the curve using the default pen. If we use fill, the default brush is used to fill the area given by the curve. Sometimes we want to both fill and draw the outline at the same time, so the operation fill draw does exactly that. We can affect the pen and brush using different operations. We can change the pen color, the brush color, the width of the pen, and the style of the pen. The short tutorial showed how the basic concepts of MetaPict works. Now we're going to look at a few applications that was built on top of the MetaPict primitives. The first application is plotting graphs of functions of one variable. At the left, we see we have four functions, f, g, h, and I. The function f is defined at the closed interval from minus 1 to 1. The function g is defined in an interval that starts at minus 1 and ends in 1, but it's of the open-closed type. At the figure at the right, we can see that the start and end of the graph is marked correctly. This example shows that the function plotter also knows how to handle simple singularities. The blue graph plots the function 1 over x. At the left, we can see that the domain of 1 over x consists of the negative real numbers and the positive real numbers. That is, we have excluded 0. This example shows how to draw a simple state machine. The state machine models how a turnstile works. The black circle indicates where to start, and this turnstile starts in the locked state. If you put in a coin, state changes to unlocked, and if we push through the turnstile, we return to a locked state. In the code, we see we have a number of circle nodes, one for each state. In the draw statement, we of course draw the circle nodes, but we also draw edges from state to state. In the first edge, we draw from L to U, from the locked to the unlocked state. The NE, northeast, means that the edge leaves the circle node in the direction of northeast, up and to the right. The label is coin, and the label time indicates whether we are going to put the label at the beginning of the edge or at the end of the edge. The beginning of the edge is 0 and the end of the edge is 1. Here, 0.1 means just after the beginning of the edge. I don't know if any of you can recognize this example, but it appears in the manual of Tikz, which is a popular drawing library for LaTeX. I'll end this talk by showing you how simple Hadith's code for the bird is. It simply draws 500 line segments. I hope you'll try out MetaPict, and I'm looking forward to seeing your results.